Hello everyone, this is Shikha and I am starting a new chapter from the literature book New Broadway. The Stalled Ox. This is the name of the chapter. You may have seen an ox in a field, but have you ever seen one inside a house? What do you think happens when an ox enters the sitting room and eats up the flowers in the vases? Either you have seen animal on road or on field. But what when an animal enters the garden area of your house, or you see it in your drawing room eating flowers from flower pot? But exactly happens in this story. We complete this story to see the situation. Hector Hughes Munro, the writer of this story, was born in 1870 and died in 1916. The Scotsman who wrote under the pen name of Saki was a talented writer of wit and wisdom. He is best remembered as a master of short stories. Most of his stories are delightfully light-hearted and make fun of human beings and their peculiarities. There is an element of satire in all his stories, including The Stalled Ox. So Hector Hughes Munro was a resident of Scotland, that is in UK, and he wrote all the stories under a pen name of Saki. What is pen name? Pen name is an adopted name by the writer that he wants to be shown on his writings. So Hector Hughes Munro wrote many short stories, and all the stories were having a kind of peculiarities. It means the strange type of thing was there in his stories, and the element of satire. It means when you are making fun of something or someone, that is called element of satire. So the exact we can see in this story, The Stalled Ox. Theophile Ashley was an artist by profession. So one of the main character of this story was Theophile Ashley, who was a painter. He was very good at his work and could paint any subject he could think of, but circumstances had forced him to specialize in pictures of cows. So he was able to make the painting of any subject or based on the ideas that were coming in his mind, but situation forced him to be well known in pictures of cows. Means he was master, or he was well known for making the pictures of cows, and people liked all the paintings of Ashley's that were having the subject of cows. On one side of his garden, there was a small field in which a neighbor kept some small cows. So there is a description of Ashley's house that he was having a garden, and next to that garden, there was a small field in which one of his neighbor kept some small cows. At noon in summertime, the cows stood deep in tall grass under the shade of a group of trees, with spots of sunlight falling on their smooth brown backs. So these cows were of brown colors, and during the summer season in the noon time, it liked to stand under the shade of the trees, surrounded by the tall grass and with the sunlight that falls on their smooth brown back. And Ashley had once painted a beautiful picture of two peaceful looking cows under a green tree with the grass and sunlight all around them. So Ashley wanted to capture this scene in his painting, and he made a beautiful painting of these two beautiful, peaceful looking cows who were standing under the shade of trees, surrounded by the tall grass and bright sunlight all around them. The Royal Academy had chosen it for its summer exhibition. The Royal Academy is an organization that promotes and encourages the arts of a growing artist, and it is in Britain. So Royal Academy held exhibitions time to time. So this paintings of Ashley is chosen by the Royal Academy for its summer exhibition. The Royal Academy, the most respected authority of its kind in the country, likes its artists to be orderly. Authority means when you have the power to give orders or to take decisions. So the Royal Academy was one of the most respected authority in Britain in the field of art, and it wanted its all painters to work in an order. If they are good at painting one sort of picture, then that is the kind of the picture they should stick to. Means what Royal Academy exactly wanted? It wanted that all the painter whose paintings are exhibited in its academy, they should paint only those paintings in which they are good. They should not do experimentation. Ashley's two attempts to paint something different were terrible failures. Means Ashley also tried to make the paintings based on different subjects besides cows, but he had to face the failure by giving these paintings. Suppose there are three painters. One painter is good in making the natural scene, one is good at making the human creature, and the third one is good in making the animal creature. So according to the Royal Academy, the painter who is good in making the natural scenery, he should not go and try to make the paintings based on the animal creature. Or the painter who is good in making the human creature, he should not do any experimentation of making the pictures of animal creatures. So Royal Academy wanted all its painters to be stick on only those subjects in which they are good in making the paintings. They were not approved by the Academy and returned, and that's why this was the reason that Ashley's two attempts, means two of his paintings that were based on different subject, they are not approved by the Academy and returned back to Ashley. Ashley then produced a shaded corner where sleepy cows stand dreaming and was back in favor once more. Back in favor means Royal Academy approved and started giving support again to the painting of Ashley. So Ashley stopped doing experimentation, and once again he made a painting where he had shown a sleepy and dreamy cow that was standing under a shaded corner, and that painting is accepted by the Royal Academy once again. After the introduction of a story, the first part started. Edla Pinksford's problem. Edla Pinksford is another character of this story. On a fine afternoon in late autumn, Ashley was finishing off a picture of grass when his neighbor Edla Pinksford began knocking very loudly on his door. So that was the incident of one of the afternoon of autumn season. Autumn is a season that comes between summer and winter, and after autumn, winter season comes. So that afternoon, Ashley was working on a picture of grass, and that was about to finish. And at the same time, his neighbor Edla Pinksford started knocking on the door very loudly. "There is an ox in my garden," she announced, explaining her noisy entrance. As she entered the house, she explained in loud voice that there is an ox in her garden. "An ox?" said Ashley rather foolishly. "An ox?" He could not imagine why Edla should want to tell him such a thing. What kind of ox? Ashley was not able to understand why his neighbor Edla was telling all these things to him. So he asked, "What kind of ox?" "Oh, I don't know what kind," answered the lady angrily. "Just an ordinary ox." Lady became angry, and she answered, "I don't know which kind of ox it is, but it was looking an ordinary ox. What I don't like about it is that it is in my garden." So the main thing of Edla was she was saying that she did not like that ox has entered her garden. "I have spent 2 weeks in that garden getting it neat and tidy for the winters." Edla was saying that she has been working in her garden for 2 weeks to make it ready for the coming winter season. "An ox walking about it in it won't help things. Besides, it is treading on flowers." Treading on is called crushing on the flowers, means walking over the flowers. So Edla was not liking that right now an ox is making her garden untidy and crushing on all the flowers. "How did it get into the garden?" asked Ashley. So Ashley asked Edla that how the ox entered in your garden.
"I think it came in by the gate," said the lady impatiently.
Impatiently means when you are feeling irritated or angry. So Edla was feeling irritated by the kind of question Ashley was asking. What kind of ox? How did it get into the garden like this? So she was showing her anger, and she said it couldn't have climbed over the wall, and I don't think anyone dropped it from an aeroplane. So she was saying about that ox that I think that ox came in by the gate, because it is not possible that an ox could climb over the wall and come in my garden, or somebody was going in the sky in an aeroplane and that person threw an ox from the aeroplane in my garden. The important question is not how it got in, but how to get it out. So Edla was saying this is not important that how the ox get into my garden, but right now it is very important to think that how we can get it out of my garden. Won't it go by itself? Said Ashley. Again, Ashley asked a very irrelevant question, that this ox will not go by itself. If it wanted to go by itself, said Edla Pinksford rather angrily, I should not have come here to talk to you about it. Again, this question made Edla rather more angry, and she asked, if the ox wanted to go by itself, why should I come to you to ask about your help? I am nearly all alone. The servant is having her afternoon off, and the cook is in bed with a headache. Now, she was telling what is the condition, means she is alone at home. Her servant is having her afternoon off, means she is not at home. And the cook who used to make meals at Edla's house, he or she was having a headache, and he or she was taking rest. At a school, they may have taught us how to remove a large ox from the small garden, I suppose. But if they did, I cannot remember what they said. Now, Edla was again giving a situation, means in a school sometime we must have read that how we can take out an animal out of the small garden. But right now, I don't remember any of those lessons. I don't remember what our teacher taught us. All I could think of was that you were a near neighbor and a person who paints cows. What I know right now, that you are my neighbor, Edla was saying to Ashley, that you are my neighbor and you make paintings on the cows. And then I thought that you must be familiar with the subjects that you painted, and that you might be of some help. Possibly I was wrong. So Edla was showing her anger by saying that I was thinking that you must be familiar with the cows and related breeds of the cows like ox and other buffaloes. So that's why after thinking this, I came to you that you may be a help for me, but possibly I was wrong, because you are asking me so irrelevant and illogical question that making me angry. Besides helping me, you are asking me more and more questions. I paint dairy cows certainly, admitted Ashley. Ashley agreed that he make paintings on the cows, but those cows are domestic and pet animals and give milk. But I do not have any experience in dealing with wandering oxen. Then he said that he is not having any experience that how to deal or how to handle an oxen who wanders on the road here and there. I have seen how cowboys do it in the movies, of course, but they always have horses and lots of other equipment. Equipment is called different type of tools. Then Ashley said that he has seen in movies that how cowboys used to tackle with these animals, because they are having horses and so many tools that are used to make the animal under control. Edla Pinksford said nothing. She led the way to her garden. After listening to Ashley's talk, Edla said nothing, and then she moved towards her garden. It normally seemed a far-sized garden, but it looked very small with the ox standing in it. Now, Edla reached her garden, and that garden was means that garden was big enough. But when an oxen was standing in that garden was looking very small. The ox was a huge animal. Why? Because ox was really a huge animal, very big animal, and for that ox, the garden seems very small. It was dull red about the head and shoulders, dirty white on the back legs, and it had large red eyes. Now, in this line, the appearance of that ox is described. described that that was having the red shoulders and hat that was a red dull red color, and he was having the back legs that was of dirty white, off white, and was having red big eyes. Ashley stood very near the gate while he studied the animal's appearance and behavior. Ashley was there on the gate of Edla's garden, and he was trying to study the behavior and the appearance, how the ox was looking. Edla Pinksford continued to say nothing. Edla Pinksford was standing without saying anything. "It's eating a flower," said Ashley at last. And after looking on that oxen for much time, then Ashley said, "See, ox is eating a flower." "How clever you are," said Edla. "You seems to notice everything. As a matter of fact, it has got 6 flowers in its mouth at the present moment." Again, Edla became irritated on the this talk or this response of the Ashley, and she said, "How clever you are! Means you are noticing everything what the ox is doing after so much time. Means you are wasting the time besides doing anything." Then she said, "Let me tell you that the truth is that ox is not eaten one flower. This time, ox is eaten 6 flowers. You can see 6 flowers are there in ox mouth." Next part of the story, the ox moves. Something had to be done. Ashley took a step or two in the direction of animal, clapped his hand and made noises like hish and shoo. Something had to be done to take that animal away from the garden. So Ashley took some step in the direction of animal and started clapping his hand, making noises like hish and shoo. You must have heard these type of sounds when any wondered cow or dog come before your house. Then you start making a sound, na, like hish hish shoo shoo, so that you can take out those animals away from the lane. The same sounds were making by Ashley. If the ox heard them, it seemed to take no notice. Ashley was thinking that ox heard these sounds, but ox was paying no attention on this noise and gestures. "If any hen should ever wander into my garden," said Edla, "I shall certainly come and ask you to frighten them out." Now Edla was looking the gestures and the silly sounds making by Ashley. Then again she, in an irritated manner, Edla said that if any hens should have wandered into my garden, means she wanted to tell any about a little or a small animal have come, then I would certainly come to you and tell you that please frighten them away, please afraid them and take them out from my garden, because you shoo beautifully. Means here Edla was making fun of the sounds made by the Ashley, like hish and shoo, because by the sound of hish and shoo you can drive out small animals, okay? But the ox was very big and huge animal. "Meanwhile, do you mind to trying to drive away the ox away?" So Edla was saying to Ashley, "Please try to do something else to take this ox away from my garden. That is my best rose bush that he is begin to eat now," she added in a calm but icy voice, as a beautiful orange color rose was crushed into the huge mouth. She was pointing towards one of the bush that was of orange color rose, that ox is going to eat that bush, and she was saying this in a very calm and a fearful voice. And after some time, the same happened, and that ox has eaten that beautiful orange color bush in his big mouth. Then Edla Pinksford's patient and icy calmness broke down. After looking at the condition of her garden, crushed flowers, all the rose bushes eaten by ox, Edla Pinkford's patience broke down, and she broke her calmness. The language she used sent the artist a few feet nearer to the ox. And when she broke her calmness and she started speaking a kind of language that forced Ashley to go closer to that ox, because Ashley also realized that Edla is becoming more angry. He picked up a thin stick and flung it against the animal's legs, because Edla wanted something else to be done by Ashley besides making the silly sound of hish and shoo. That's why Ashley picked up a thin stick and started moving it up and down against the animal's leg. For a long moment, the ox stopped turning roses into lunch while it looked with great interest at the stick thrower. Now, Ashley was trying to hit that animal, that ox, that huge animal, with a thin stick. So ox stopped eating those roses as its lunch and started looking at that person who was trying to hit with a thin stick on its leg. Edla glared with equal interest and more obvious anger at the same person. And this all things is glared is called continuously looked by Edla, and she was looking all these things with interest, but at the same time she was getting very angry because Ashley was doing the kind of thing. Ashley was opting out the measures that was all fail, that all seemed fail for this huge animal, means by making some silly sounds or by just taking a thin stick, moving thin stick here and there. You cannot take this big animal out from the garden. As the animal neither lowered its head nor stamped its feet, Ashley tried throwing another stick. So Ashley was doing it so that he can take this animal away from the garden, but that was a very huge animal that was not ready to lower his head or even stamp his feet. Means it stamp his feet is called to move its feet up and down, means showing some sign that yet it's ready, it is ready to go out from the garden. But ox was not showing any sign of going out of the garden. So what Ashley did, Ashley tried throwing another stick. He took another stick and tried to throw another stick towards the animal. The ox seemed to realize at once that it was being asked to move. So after these all measures that taken by the Ashley, ox already realized that yes, this person wanted me to take out of this garden. It gave a hurried final bite to the flowers and walked quickly up the garden. Till now, ox has realized that this man wanted it to take away from the garden, and that's why after realizing it at last, ox eaten all the remaining flowers quickly and started moving to other side of the garden. Ashley ran to turn it back towards the gate, but only succeeded in making it walk faster in the opposite direction. Ashley was trying hard to move that ox away from the place where it was standing and eating all the flowers, and he was succeeded. And he wanted to take that ox to gate side so that it can move that ox away from the that gate. But what exactly happened? It went towards the opposite direction and started moving to that direction. Soon it had crossed a small area of grass between garden and house and pushed its way through the open French window into the morning room. French window is a window made of glass, means that is the that is working as a door between the house and the garden area, means you can go inside the house from that French window and come out in the garden. And morning room is called drawing room. So what exactly happened? The garden area, the grass area that was connecting the way of garden and home, that was already crossed by ox, and now ox entered in drawing room through that French window. Some flowers stood in vase around the room, and the animal continued its lunch. After reaching drawing room, ox looked here and there. There he found some flowers that were kept in the flower pot, and it started eating those flowers. Meanwhile, Ashley imagined that a slightly dangerous look had come into his eyes. Meanwhile, Ashley also realized that because of making so many disturbance or troubled to that animal, the animal was feeling a type of anger, and that can be seen in its eyes, and he stopped trying to make it go where it did not want to go. So now Ashley stopped making more trials to take that animal away from the place where from which place that animal was not ready to move. Next part of the story, Ashley gets his equipment. "Mr. Ashley," said Edla in a shaking voice, "I asked you to drive that ox out of my garden, but I did not ask you to drive it into my house." After looking at that ox that was right now in Edla's drawing room, she became very angry, and in that angry voice, she said Ashley that she wanted that ox to take out of the garden. And Ashley exactly done opposite, and by mistake, unknowingly, Ashley drive that ox to go towards the drawing room of Edla. "It must have it somewhere on my property. I prefer it to be in the garden than in the morning room." Edla was very angry, and she was saying that if this ox needed to be anywhere in my property, then I would like to be present in garden rather than anywhere else. Cattle driving is not my profession, said Ashley. Now, Ashley was also responding hard, and he was saying that to drive the cattle away from the garden or house is not my profession. If I remember rightly, I told you so at the beginning. And Ashley reminded Adela that I told you this thing in the beginning when you came to my house, that I don't know how to take the animals out from the garden and home. I quite agree, answered the lady, and painting pretty pictures of pretty little cow is what you are good at. And then lady is answering that, okay, I am agree that you said this thing to me, and what is your profession? You made the beautiful paintings of the beautiful little cows, and you are good in that only. Perhaps you would like to do a nice one of that ox having lunch in my morning room. So now Adela was again saying this thing in a very irritated manner, that you like to paint little cows, now what is the new thing for you? Now go and draw a new painting of that ox that is right now in my drawing room and eating the flowers in its lunch. Ashley immediately began walking away. After listening to Adela, Ashley just turned out a thing in his mind, and he began to walk away from Adela's garden. Where are you going? Screamed Adela. When Ashley was going, Adela started asking, where are you going? To fetch my equipments, was the answer. Fetch is called to bring, and equipments are tools. Ashley answered that he was going to bring his tools. Equipment, I don't want to start using a rope. Everything in the room will get destroyed if there is a struggle. Adela was supposing that Ashley was preparing to take that animal out from drawing room by the use of rope. So she was saying, don't use a rope, because if you try to take that animal out with the use of rope, everything in my drawing room can be destroyed because of that struggle. But the artist marched out of the garden. In a couple of minutes, he returned with a stool and his painting things. But Ashley did not listen to anything. He marched out, is called went out from the garden. And after 2 minutes, he came back, and there was a stool and his painting things, means the canvas was there, the colors, the brushes, all things were there with him. Do you mean to say you are going to sit down quietly and paint that animal while it's destroying my morning room? Gasped Adela. Gasp is called with a long breath. Now Adela was again becoming very angry, because nothing is happening according to her interest. And she said to Ashley that what you are making, what you are thinking, you are going to make a picture of that ox, and right now that ox is destroying my drawing room, and instead of taking that ox away from my drawing room, you are preparing to make the picture, the painting of that ox. It was your idea, said Ashley, setting his thing in place. Ashley said, no, this was your idea. You told me to make the picture of ox instead of making the pictures of the cute little cows. So he was arranging his things and telling this thing to Adela. I won't allow it. I absolutely won't allow it, screamed Adela. Now Adela became more and more angry, and she was saying, I will not allow you to make a painting of that animal that is right now destroying everything in my drawing room.
I don't see that there is anything you can do about it, said the artist. Ashley said to Adela that you cannot do anything in this matter. It's not even your ox. This is not your pet ox, so it is not going to listen to you anymore. Also, you seem to forget that the cook has a headache. She may be just falling asleep, and your screaming will wake her up. You should think more of other people. Adela was becoming very angry, and in that anger, she was speaking in a loud voice. And that's why Ashley reminded her that you maybe forgot that your cook is having headache, or she may be just falling asleep, and because of your loud voice, she will wake up. You should think more about the other peoples of your home besides yourself. The man is mad, exclaimed Adela. A moment later, it was Adela herself who appeared to go mad. Edla was in great anger and he said that Ashley became mad. But anybody could say after looking at Edla that this was she who herself turns mad because of looking at the condition of her house that is turned a mashed up by that ox. The ox had finished the flowers and the cover of the book, it appeared to be thinking of leaving the rather small room. After eating all the flowers of drawing room and after eating even the cover of the book, some books were kept on the table and ox had eaten the cover of those books. Now ox was feeling a little uncomfortable because that was a small room for it and it wanted to go out from that room. Ashley noticed it restlessness and threw in some more flowers from the garden to keep it inside the room. Ashley realized that now ox was feeling uncomfortable in that room and it wanted to go out in the garden, but Ashley wanted it to keep in the room for a little longer because Ashley was preparing to make a painting of that ox in the drawing room, and that's why Ashley went outside, brought some more flowers from the garden and keep them inside the room so that ox could eat that flowers and it find a way to stay in that drawing room for a long time. I shall go to a public library and get them to telephone for the police, said Edla, and she left. After looking at Ashley's behavior, that Ashley himself wanted that ox to be stay in Edla's drawing room, Edla's anger has no limit, and then she decided to go to public library, and through phone call he was preparing to call police for both of them.
Fourth and last part of the story, success. Some minutes later, the ox stepped carefully out of the morning room, stared seriously at the human who no longer bothered it with the sticks, and then walked heavily but quickly through the garden gate. After some time, after finishing all the flowers threw by Ashley from the garden, ox made its move to go away from the drawing room, and it was looking continuously at Ashley, who was not bothering him with sticks, with noisy sounds. And then ox walks away slowly towards the garden side and then quickly went out from the garden gate. Ashley packed up his equipments and followed. Ashley also got up, packed up all his painting tools and followed ox through the garden gate. It was the turning point in Ashley's artistic life. So this painting proved a turning point in Ashley's artistic life. His amazing picture ox in a morning room late autumn was one of the most talked about work of the next Paris art exhibition. The painting that Ashley has made sitting in Edla's drawing room of that ox was ox in a morning room late autumn, and this painting got a huge success that was exhibit in the next Paris art exhibition, and when it was exhibited at Munich it was bought by the German government, and when the same painting was exhibited in another exhibition at Munich, then it was bought by the German government. So this kind of success bought by ox in the morning room late autumn in Ashley's artistic life. From that moment, he was known everywhere as a successful painter. After painting that ox painting, Ashley was known as a successful painter everywhere. He could paint any subject he liked. Now, he was not confined to paint only on cow subject. Now, whatever the subject he liked, he started making the painting on that subject. 2 years later, even the Royal Academy was happy to give a great space on its wall to his large painting, African Apes Wrecking a Bedroom. Apes are the large monkeys and wrecking means destroying a bedroom. So the name of the painting was African Apes Wrecking a Bedroom. As you can see in the picture, this is made by Ashley, and the Royal Academy, that was known for giving or receiving the paintings of the painters who are strict on that work, that Royal Academy itself giving a chance to receive a painting painted by Ashley on a different subject besides the cows. Ashley Ashley presented Edla Pinksford with a new copy of a book the ox had eaten and a couple of the fine flowering plants for her garden, but she has never forgiven him. Ashley was very much aware about that, how much Edla angry with him. That's why Ashley gave her a gift of copy of a new book that ox had eaten while it was there in Edla's drawing room, and he also presented a couple of fine flowering plants for Edla's garden, because most of her flowering plants were crushed by ox. But Edla became never happy with Ashley, and she had never forgiven him. So we can see that just because of a very strange incident proved a turning point in a painter's life. So how a strange thing could bring a big change in your life, we cannot say. So we should keep on trying doing new things. We keep on trying to accept new challenges, whether without considering about the result sometime. Maybe that can bring the positivity or success in your life. So with this message, I end my video here. Meet you soon.